The U.S. Department of Agriculture is using millions of dollars in federal grant funds to give struggling rural communities in Oklahoma better access to essential services. This past Monday, state USDA leaders distributed help to a handful of school districts in Broken Bow and Ida Belle. Steve Shaw made the trip to southern Oklahoma and joins us now with more. Steve.
Rich, this isn't leftover federal COVID-19 money. It's funding that the U.S. Department of Agriculture says is available each year. And they want more people in rural Oklahoma communities to know it's there and to apply for it.
Brandy Blaylock is principal and superintendent of Glover Elementary School in Broken Bow in southeast Oklahoma. Brandy also drives the school bus, just one of the hats she has to wear. Glover only has 68 students, and because of that, funding is tight.
The biggest challenge is that we're in such a rural area. We have a low socioeconomic background in many of our students, and we struggle to find resources to help us. We see almost a family environment. A lot of students struggle with things at home, but we as a family have, a school family have come together and we're able to help these students. I mean, I see students get angel tree bags with Christmas gifts that normally wouldn't have Christmas. I see people coming together to give the students winter coats, different things like that. Matter of fact, we have two students that my husband and I are about to adopt that we've gotten so close to here.
Three, one, two, three. Great.
This past Monday, Blaylock and representatives of three other rural Oklahoma school districts formally received $50,000 grants from the United States Department of Agriculture. More specifically, they're what are called community facility grants through USDA Rural Development. Former Anadarko City Manager Kenneth Korn is Executive Director of Oklahoma USDA Rural Development. His message Monday was there's more from where that came from.
So like if you guys wanted to do something, like if you wanted to network the schools together, like with either Career Tech or a college, or if you guys wanted to share classes and resources through distance learning, you have an opportunity to apply through that grant to do that. You can even potentially do telemedicine through it. Like if you wanted to partner with the hospital or a health clinic and let them be your school nurse program through telemedicine, you could potentially do that. So there's options there. The thing I really like to tell folks is that with all the different programs we have at Rural Development, don't assume that you don't qualify for things.
I'm turning some air on. It's been a while since I had to use air.
Blaylock's Glover School has already used that money to buy this brand new school bus.
Tinted windows are nice.
Blaylock says this bus replaces one that didn't have air conditioning.
It's hot.
Yes, we had to bring bottles of water before we got this bus during the summer months.
For the kids?
Yes.
And for you?
Yes.
Cassie Garrett represents Hayworth Public Schools. They're using that $50,000 to buy some wheels too.
This money will allow us to purchase a new ag trailer to help with our ag department. Ag is a very big thing in Hayworth. We have many students that are involved in the FFA program. I know it's supposed to be like top of the line, decked out to where they can move multiple different types of animals and multiple animals at the same time.
And it's pulled by what, a pickup truck?
It's pulled by one of our ag trucks, yes sir.
So, I mean, this is like, you know, I mean, this can be a game changer for your ag program.
Can, and it helps keep kids in our district. You know, each school has to try to find that niche that the kids want to be involved in, and with our ag program, that's one of the niches that get kids to come to our district and to keep them at our district.
Randall Irwin is superintendent of Clayton Public Schools, which is 40 miles northeast of Antlers in Pushmataha County. 256 students attend their elementary, middle, and high schools. They're using their money to purchase high-end computer equipment.
So this will allow us to offer the top-notch technology courses that we need for our high school students to compete.
There are students in rural school districts that can excel as well.
Oh.
You just got to give them a shot.
We, year before last, we had the number one chemistry student in the state. This last year, we had the number one chemistry student in our region. We hadn't gone to state yet. We've had the number one and number two math student. Number of students going to state competition. We can compete if we can just get the resources to help our students.
Also here in Ida Belle on Monday afternoon, Corn presented a $24.7 million grant to address broadband needs, and there are a lot of them, in Choctaw and Bryan counties.
On behalf of President Biden,
Corn also presented Ida Belle Mayor Craig Young a $45,000 grant so Ida Belle can purchase this 10-wheel heavy-duty dump truck. Mayor Young says such a monster truck will allow Ida Belle to be more efficient when paving their roads.
Someone came to visit with us and said, hey, there's some money there. And of course, money, we always excited for money. And so he helped us apply for a grant, and we was fortunate enough to be one of the ones to receive the grant.
And it's something that, you know, it's something that in the future it could help Ida Belle.
Oh, yeah. I mean, anytime you can get a grant, it helps for other money. You can use money in other places.
Every community in Oklahoma is in need. And the thing that I keep reminding people is in rural parts of our state, a lot of these infrastructure that's there in these communities, all of them are over 100 years old. They're crumbling. They've outlived their usefulness. And so they desperately need help to do these upgrades. And I think that's the thing the president's been real clear about, is that rural communities, their infrastructure has been left behind the last 30 and 40 years.
Something that's very important to understand is if these rural schools don't have top-end technology available, their gifted students, some of them have to drive 50 or 60 miles to neighboring school districts to get that work done. That can be untenable for many of these students.